ho, we are recording. I made the German review 1 minute ago and I rambled about all the takes I needed for this here right now because I had so much problems yesterday with the cameras and microphones and stuff. So I stopped yesterday and now it's a new beginning. And the first thing I have to say is we will hear this time, the first time, hear my new Dosa cap, the blue new Dosa cap. This got a Jensen C12K speaker, 100 watt speaker. Sounds a little bit fatter than my red one. And yeah, I like it very much. Please check out Dosa cap. Link will be in the description below too. And we are here with the vintage V100 PGM. Yeah, and I didn't Google it, but the PGM stands, in my opinion, for Peter Green and Gary Moore. So PG, Peter Green, GM, Gary Moore. Peter Green had a guitar that looks almost like this. And then Gary Moore played his guitar. And now Kirk Hammett got this guitar. And it looks almost the same. It got this reversed pickup, neck pickup. And these two different kind of knobs. And the history behind this, in what I read some years ago, is, if I'm not wrong, is Peter Green's technician soldered him a new pickup in the neck position and made it wrong. So he had an out-of-phase sound in the middle position. And Peter Green liked it and, yeah, kept it like that. And he played stuff like, I don't know, Albatross with Fleetwood Mac. With this sound, I'm not sure right now. And the reason for the knobs is so they can feel on which pickup they are. Joe Bonamassa stole this idea of the knobs. Yeah, but it's from Gary Moore or Peter Green, I'm not sure right now. So that's the special thing about this guitar, okay? We got this out of phase sound and the different knobs. Yeah, let's go through the specifications. We got a mahogany body, three-piece body, got a nice grain. Can't say anything bad about it. We got a maple top and maple veneer, very nice grade. We got a mahogany neck, and these are three stripes, mahogany, and they run under the neck pickup to the tip of the headstock. We got here no glued on headstock or something. Really, three pieces from here to there. And we got a nice C shape. It's not too thick, not too thin. Fits everyone, fits this guitar in my opinion. Very comfortable. Yeah. And we got a lot of sustain on this guitar. You will see, this guitar can really sing. We got a rosewood fretboard, yes. And yeah, it was a little bit dirty. The frets also a little bit dirty, okay? These are the only bad points I got on this guitar. Dirty fretboard and dirty frets. Otherwise, it's a nice piece of wood, the fretboard. The leveling of the frets is good too. We got here really low action. I was surprised. 2 millimeters out of the box. And one, something like 1.8 millimeter here on the high E. Yeah, very comfortable to play. We got crown inlays on this guitar. They are perfectly centered. And we got here no, you know, wood fillers or glue residue or something. Perfectly done. We got a graphite nut. And it's perfectly slotted. No problems on this. Maybe, yeah, a little bit dirty too. But okay. That's it. We got a scale length of 628 millimeters. That's the standard single cut scale length. I always have to think on this rock sound, you know, where you make this. And the thick E string goes a little bit out of tune and then comes back again. What I mean is this here. I mean this wow, bugger, 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 and then it's back in tune again. Two Wilkinson humbuckers, yes. And yeah, the special thing on this guitar is we got an out of phase sound in the middle position. Three-way switch, by the way, very nice. No problem on this one. It's, you know, it doesn't feel loose in the middle position or something. No, we got neck position, middle position, bridge position, and I will show you them how they sound clean mode. We are here in the USA mode on my Ignator. That's something like a Fender mode. Okay? Neck position. And now the middle position. Can you hear that? It sounds like we would play through a telephone or something. Sounds like a fixed wah-wah sound or something. And now the bridge pickup. I hope you could hear it already. We got here really this fat single cut sound, yeah? Neck pickup. Yeah, really wants to sing, got a warm sound. I really, really like it. Let's continue with the specs. Yeah, we got no pickguard on this guitar. We really got no pickguard, okay? It doesn't come with the parcel or something. This guitar got no pickguard. We got here no holes on this guitar the way you see it here, okay? And it's good, like this. Two volume and two tone pots, of course, all 500K, and a three-way switch, so we can switch between, of course, neck pickup, both pickups out of phase sound, and the bridge pickup, okay? And when I talk about this, let me show you here quickly the electronic cavities. And the electronic cavity looks good. Let me say that the cover is shielded too, okay? That's good. And yeah, what can we see here? The whole cavity is shielded with graphite lacquer. They even connected the graphite lacquer here to the metal housing of the pots. So that's very good. We got here alpha pots, little alpha pots, 500K pots. And yeah, you could split these pickups if you want to. We got the cables for it. And so far, the wiring, everything looks good. Now quickly here, the cavity for the three-way switch. Shielded with graphite lacquer too, and shielded, the cover is shielded too. Everything looks good so far. Let's continue. So I hope you could see that everything in the electronic cavity is okay. We got Wilkinson vintage tuners, and these work flawlessly. We got here the green tuning packs. That's fine. Mr. Wilkinson works together with Vintage. And Vintage is something like the house brand of JHS, John Hornby Skews. Vintage is a John Hornby Skews product. And yeah, they work together. We got Wilkinson tuners. I thought at first we would have here Wilkinson Tunematic Bridge, Wilkinson Tailpiece 2, but no, we got a Sung Il. So we got a Chinese, if I'm not wrong, tailpiece. And yeah, the BM-002. Works flawlessly, no problem so far. We got here this little wire going on the tunematic bridge, but it doesn't make any noises or something, okay? Just to let you know. Yeah, the color, they say lemon drop. In my opinion, this is not a lemon drop anymore. In my opinion, this is something like iced tea. Very nice color, looks really, really good together with the veneer. Perfectly made, perfectly done. So what did they forget? The nut, did I mention the nut? We got a graphite nut, perfectly slotted, no problems. White graphite nut. We got a cream binding around the fretboard, perfectly made. And we got a cream bind. We got a cream binding around the body, perfectly made. So no problems so far. And the input jack here and the plate is completely metal, okay? Metal plate. We got here this slight angled body shape, but the heel itself is the standard LP shape. For some reason. So we still got the problem that we cannot reach the last frets very easily. So it feels like a 59 single cut, you know, still. And you have to really stretch your fingers a little bit to get to the last fret. The weight is 4.3 kilograms. That were all the specs. I'm good with the time, I think. Let me show you here the neck pick up the volume pot, and you will hear that the volume pot, you know, cuts a little bit high end off, okay? Okay, and now the bridge pickup quickly. So both volume pots cut a little bit high end off. You know, the original could be like this too, I'm not sure. Normally, if I got a guitar like this, I set my amp, you know, a little bit brighter. And if it's too bright, I go with the volume a little bit down. There's a sweet spot around 8 or 7. If the sound is now too bright for someone, you turn the volume a little bit down, around 7 or 8. And there's something like a sweet spot. Tone pots make the sound very dark. We got here really a woman tone going on. Okay, neck pick up, tone pot all the way down. And let's give it a little bit gain. I know that Gary never played this with a woman tone, but I have to think constantly on Gary Moore when I got this guitar in my hand. You can make the woman tone on the bridge pickup too, by the way. And now the middle position with a little bit gain. Sounds like me always like a fixed wah-wah, you know, fixed wah-wah sound. And of course, in the middle position, you can work with both tone knobs and shape this sound a little bit more. For some reason, in the middle position and the neck pick up, tone pot a little bit down, sounds almost a little bit like a banjo. Get here a fat single cut sound, in my opinion. The middle position is a little bit more special. The more gain you give the neck pickup, the more it starts to sing. The more gain you give the middle position, the more it sounds, you know, like a wah-wah sound, like a fixed wah-wah sound. And the bridge pickup, the same, okay? The guitar starts to sing. And when I say it starts to sing, that's how Gary Moore did it on stage, you know? Gain, volume, and then this fat single cut sound, and you got this everlasting feedback. Really, really nice. Let me play a little bit with the AC tone, bridge pickup. We'll be right back. like it. And now neck pickup, the same amount of gain. Middle position. Yeah, you can use the middle position for that, of course. You can play it a little bit and it sounds thin, and then in the right moment when the drummer hits in and the bass player, you can switch to your bridge pickup and get the full fat sound. That will work, of course, too. So yeah, nice rocking single cut sounds, in my opinion, works really good and well. And it wants to sing and it got resonance and it got sustain. The way it should be on a guitar like this. We have to use more gain. I mean, Kirk Hammett got this original guitar right now from a Telica, so we have to use more gain, right? It's a very, very fat sounding guitar. In my opinion, I should take the deep switch here off, so it's not as fat, you know? That was the out of phase middle position. So it can rock, it can metal. It's not its main, you know, area, metal. In my opinion, it's too dark sounding guitar. Sounds not bad, but yeah, not the main area. But yeah, to finish this video, let's drop tune the guitar and let's see what it can do there. Final words, okay? You get here for 459 euro, or a little bit less, maybe a little bit more, depends on where you want to buy it. You get here a very, very good single cut. Only bad points were the dirty fretboard and the dirty frets. Otherwise, everything else is fine. It's exactly what it looks like. It's the fat single cut, really fat single cut body, okay? And it got this fat, thick, rich sound. Can sound very dark, yeah? Also got this special sound in the middle position, and yeah, look-wise, it looks almost like the guitar we know from Gary Moore and Peter Green. And yeah, for $459, it's a good guitar, really. I can recommend you this guitar. If you love a single cut, if you love this thick sound, if you want a guitar like this with this look, I mean, look at this again, check it out. And yeah, if you got questions, please come in my Facebook groups. All the links are in the description below. Please also check out Dozer Caps, check out Musikwein. And yeah, I hope you liked the video and have a nice day.